continue with the chapter solutions. Okay, so we will start with the problem. We will do the problem and then we will move to the next part. Okay, so the first problem which is given in your textbook. Calculate the mole fraction of ethylene glycol. Ethylene glycol formula they have given in a solution. Solution means ethylene glycol is mixed with water. That you should keep in your mind. Okay. Containing 20% of C2H6O2 by mass. Okay. So first what is given we will write. What is given? 20% of ethylene glycol, C2H6O2. So, solution means what? Ethylene glycol is mixed with water. 20% of ethylene glycol by mass means mass of ethylene glycol they have given, C2H6O2. Mass of ethylene glycol is 20%. 20% means it is 20 grams. Okay. So, remaining 80 grams will be mass of water. Mass of water will be remaining 80 grams. Okay, so 80 grams water and 20 grams ethylene glycol. That only will give 20% solution. So, solution means always it is mixed with water. Okay, now formula I have to write. What they are asking you to find out? Calculate the mole fraction. Okay, so mole fraction formula we have studied in the previous video. Mole fraction of A is equal to number of moles of A divided by total number of moles. Okay, so mole fraction of ethylene glycol if I want. Okay, mole fraction of ethylene glycol is C2H6O2 will be number of moles of ethylene glycol divided by total number of moles. Total number of moles means ethylene glycol mole plus water moles. Okay. Now, number of moles value we don't have in the question. Only mass value is given. So, what is the formula for number of moles? I told you in the previous video. Number of moles is equal to mass by molar mass. Mass by molar mass. So we have to calculate number of moles of ethylene glycol, number of moles of water, then I have to substitute in this formula and I have to find out the mole fraction of ethylene glycol. Okay. So first I will find out the number of moles of ethylene glycol. So, number of moles of ethylene glycol, C2H6O2 will be is equal to mass by molar mass. What is the mass given? 20 grams they have given in the question. So, 20 divided by molar mass. We have to calculate the molar mass. Okay. So, how to calculate the molar mass? Always you must by heart the mass of some substances. Okay. So, hydrogen's mass is 1, carbon mass is 12, oxygen mass is 16, sodium 23, chlorine 35.5. Okay. Calcium 40, sulfur 32, these mass, nitrogen 14. This and all you must by heart. Now, molar mass I have to calculate. Molar mass. What is the mass of carbon? 12. How many carbons are there? 2. So, 12 into 2. Plus, what is the mass of hydrogen? 1. How many hydrogens are there? 6. So, 1 into 6. Plus, oxygen. It is 16. How many oxygens are there? 2. So, I will get 20 divided by 24 plus 6. Plus 32. Okay, so 20 divided by 24 plus 6 is 30. 30 plus 32, 62 I will be getting. So, number of moles is equal to 20 divided by 62. I can cancel it in two table. 2 tens are 20. 2 31s are. Okay. So if I divide this, what will happen? So 31 10. Okay, so point add 0, 31 2s are 62, 31 3s are 93. So 3 times it will go 93, balance 7, 0, 2s are 62, balance 8, add 0, again 2 times. Okay, so 0.322 moles. So number of moles of ethylene glycol will be equal to 0.322 moles. Okay, now I have found out this number of moles of ethylene glycol. Next, what I have to find out? Number of moles of water I have to find out. So again, what is the number of moles of water? Number of moles of water is equal to mass by molar mass. What is the mass given in the question? 80. Molar mass of water. Water is H2O. Okay, so hydrogen it is 1 into 2 plus oxygen 16 into 1. So 80 divided by 2 plus 16, I will get 18. Cancel in 2 table. 2 9s are 18. 2 40s are. So divide 40 by 9. 9 4s are 36, 4.0, 9 4s are 36, so 4.44, it will be going on, yes or no? So number of moles of water is equal to 4.44 moles, okay? Now I know all these values, I am going to substitute in the mole fraction formula. So what I will get? So after decimal here 3 points are there, so here also I will put another 4. Okay, so mole fraction of C2H6O2 is equal to number of moles of ethylene glycol divided by total number of moles, 0.322 plus 4.444. So I will be getting 0.322 divided by, if I add this, I will be getting 4.766. Yes or no? So to remove the decimal, what I will do? Into 1000 I will be doing. So when I do, I will get 322 divided by 4766. Okay. So I can cancel this in two table. 2 1s are, 2 6s are, 1s are, 2 2s are, 2 3s are, 2 8s are, 3s are. Okay. So I can divide this. Okay. So it is very difficult to divide. So I can use logarithm for doing this. Okay. So we are going to calculate this by logarithm. Okay. If it is division, you have to do subtraction in logarithm. Okay. So if it is division, what you have to do? You have to do subtraction in logarithm. So I have to take log of 161 and I have to subtract it. Why I am subtracting? Because it is division. That is why I am subtracting. I have to subtract this with log of 2383. I have to subtract this with log of 2383. So now, how to take the log of this number? Listen carefully, how to take the log of this number? 161. How many digits are there? 3 digits are there. So if it is 3 digits, means I have to keep 2 point. Okay, I have to keep 2 points. If it is 4 digits, I have to keep 3 point. If it is 5 digits, I have to keep 4 point. If it is 2 digits, I have to keep 1 point. If it is 1 digit, I have to keep 0 point. Okay. Now, in the logarithm table, how it will be? Okay. So, the logarithm table, it will start from 0, 1, 2, 3 till 9. It will be there. Okay. And here this side, it will start from, the row will start from 10, 11, 12. Okay. And this is your big column. and this mean difference column will be there this side. It will start from 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, up to 9 will be there in this column. Now, 161 means in the 16th row, I have to see the first column. So, 10, 11, 12 is there, yes or no? So, in that, in 16th row, what is the value given in the first column? First column that you have to say. So it is 2068. Okay. So now I have taken the log of 161. Now what I am going to do is I am going to take the log of this number. So in 23rd row, in the big column, I have to see 8th column, and in the mean difference column, I have to see the third column. So in 23, what is the 8 value? 3766 will be there, and the mean difference 3 value is 6. So it will be like this. So I have to add these two numbers. Okay. So 3766 plus 6, I will be getting 3772. So 3.3772. If there is only one number, means only in the big column I will see. But two numbers means in the big column I have to see in the number 8, and in the mean difference column, small column, I have to see in the number 3, and I have to add both the digits, and that will be my logarithm value. Okay. Now I am going to subtract these two numbers. Okay. So 8 minus 2 is 6. So 1, this will become 9, and this will become 1. Yes or no? So this will be 9, this will be 2, so this will become 1. Yes or no? So I will be getting 8. So here this is 1 minus 3. 1 minus 3 means it is minus 2. Minus sign we should not put into, I should put 2 bar. Okay. So 2 bar 0.8296 is my answer for logarithm, but this is not the answer for this one. Okay, after taking the log, you should take the anti-logarithm. Okay, now in your log book, you turn to page anti-logarithm page. Okay, so anti-logarithm means 0.82 is given. 0.82. So anti-logarithm columns will be like this, rows will be like this, 0.10, 0.11, 0.12, like that. Okay. So now you have to see in 0.82 row. So in 0.82 row, you must see the 9th column value, and in the mean difference, you have to see the 6th value. Okay. So 0.82, what is the 9th column value?
6745.
And what is the mean difference? 6 value?
9.
So now I have to add these two. So I will be getting 6745 plus 9. So I will be getting 6754. Okay. So 6754 I am getting. Okay. Here it is minus 2. With this number, the point before the decimal, that number is there, yes or no? With this number, I have to add plus 1. So what will happen if I add plus 1? Minus 2 plus 1 will become minus 1. Minus 1 means I have to keep the number like this. I have to put 1 0 and I have to keep point. Okay. Minus 1 means 10 I have to add before this number, and I have to keep the point. So what is the answer for this sum? 0.06754 is the answer for this point. So this is my mole fraction of C2H6O2. Next problem. Calculate the molarity of the solution containing 5 grams of NaOH, sodium hydroxide, in 450 ml solution. So first, what we have to find out? To find, what I should find? Calculate the molarity. I should find the molarity. What is the formula for molarity? In the previous video, I told you molarity is equal to number of moles divided by volume of solution in liters. Volume of solution in liters. Okay. So now what and all is given in my solution. In my question. So even if you don't know the answer, you write this formula to find given everything. They will give 1 mark or 1.5 marks in the exam for this. Okay. So given, what is given? Mass is given. Mass of NaOH is given as 5 grams. Okay. And volume they have given. Volume of solution they have given 450 ml. But what is the formula? Volume of solution in liters. Yes or no? So this milliliters, I have to change it into liters. Okay, so 1 liter is equal to, I know, 1000 milliliter. Okay, so if I want to convert milliliter into liter, I have to divide by 1000. So I will be getting 450 divided by 1000 liters. Like this I will be getting. Okay, so I can cancel this. 5 table, 5 nines are 45, 5 20s are. So I am going to take it as 9 by 20 liters. So this will be my volume of solution. Now, volume of solution in liters, I have, what is the numerator? Number of moles. Number of moles value, it is not given in my question. So I have to calculate that. So I told you, what is the formula to calculate number of moles? Number of moles is equal to mass by molar mass. What is the mass given? 5 molar mass of NaOH. Sodium mass is 23 into 1 plus oxygen's mass is 16 into 1 plus hydrogen's mass is 1 into 1. Okay, so I will be getting 5 divided by 23 plus 16 plus 1. So I will be getting 5 divided by 40. Okay. So 5 divided by 40, I can cancel it. 5 ones are 5 eights are. So number of moles, I am taking it as 1 by 8. Okay. I am not converting it into decimal. But if you want, you can do it with decimal also. Okay. So here also it is fraction, that is why here also I took it as fraction. Now I will calculate the molarity. Molarity is equal to number of moles, 1 by 8 divided by volume of solution in liters, 9 by 20. So 1 by 8, 9 by 20, if it goes that side, it will become 20 by 9. 2 table, 2 4s are, 2 10s are, 2 2s are, 2 5s are. So I will be getting 5 by 18, so it is very easy to divide 5 by 18. So 0.0 18 2s are 36. Okay, so I will be getting 14 0 and 18 5s are is what? 40 5 ones are 5 plus 4 9 18 6s are 48 10. Okay, so 18 sevens are 56, 126. Okay, so what is 18 eights are 64, 40, 144. So 7 times it will go. Okay, so 126. So again it will become 14. Yes or no? And again it will become 7. So it will go on. So molarity I can round it off as 0.278. What is the unit for molarity? In the numerator it is moles. In the denominator it is liters. Okay. So moles, if that liters comes to the numerator, it will become liter inverse. So moles per liter. This is the unit for molarity. Third problem, Calculate the molality. They are asking molality. So what is the formula for molality? Molality is equal to number of moles of solute. Here, which is the solute, which is the solvent? So 2.5 grams of ethanoic acid. Ethanoic acid in. Ethanoic acid in means ethanoic acid is dissolved in. Okay, ethanoic acid is dissolved in benzene means ethanoic acid is the solute, benzene is the solvent, because I am adding ethanoic acid to benzene. Okay, so ethanoic acid is the solute and benzene is the solvent. So number of moles of the solute divided by mass of the solvent in kilograms. This is the formula for molality. Yes or no? So what and all is given in the question? Mass of solute is given. What is solute? Ethanoic acid. Mass of ethanoic acid they have given 2.5 grams. Okay. And mass of the solvent. Which is the solvent here? Benzene is the solvent. They have given as 75 grams. But in the formula, I need a mass of the solvent in kilograms. Yes or no? So, this grams, I have to convert it into kilograms. You know, 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 grams. So, if I want to convert grams to kilograms, I have to divide it by 1000. So, 75 divided by 1000. So, 25 table, it will go. 25 threes are 25 40s are, it will go. So I am keeping it as 3 by 40 kilograms. This is my mass of solvent. Now denominator I have got here. So numerator I have to get number of moles. So how will I calculate number of moles? Number of moles is equal to, what is the formula? Mass by molar mass. Okay, so number of moles of solute, which is the solute here? Ethanoic acid, CH3COOH. So what is the mass given? 2.5. Molar mass I have to calculate. Carbon's mass is 12 into 1 plus hydrogen 1 into 3 plus carbon 12 into 1 plus oxygen 16 into 1 plus another oxygen 16 into 1 plus hydrogen 1 into 1. So 2.5 divided by, so if I add all these things, 12 plus 3 plus 12 plus 16 plus 16 plus 1. So 5 plus 2, 7 plus 6, 13, 19, 20, 2 plus 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 60 I will be getting. Yes or no? So 2.5 divided by 60 I will be getting. So if I want to remove the decimal, into 10 I will be doing. So I will get 25 by 600. This I can cancel in 5 table. 5 5s are 25. 5 1s are, 5 120s are. Yes or no? And 5 1s are 524 times it will go. So number of moles I am keeping it as 1 by 24. Okay, so now I can calculate the molality. Now mass of the solvent I have got, number of moles also I have got. So I can calculate the molality now. So molality is equal to number of moles 1 by 24 by mass of the solvent in kilograms, 3 by 40. So 3 by 40, if it comes that side, it will become 40 by 3. Okay, so this I can cancel in 2 table. 2 20s are, 2 12s are. Okay, again 2 table, 2 10s are, 2 6 are. Okay, so I will be getting 10 by, again I can cancel in 2 table. 2 5s are, 2 3s are. So 5 by 9 I will be getting. So if I divide, I will be getting 0.09. 5s are 45. Balance 5. Again 0. 9 5s are. So 0.555 it is going. So I can round it off as molality is equal to 0.556. You can round it off as 6. okay, and then it is moles, okay, denominator is kg, if it comes to the numerator, kg inverse, okay. So this is my answer. So I hope you understood all the problems today. The remaining I will teach in the next class.